from the Bhagavad Gita as it is. Second chapter, text number 17. Given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Recorded on November 22, 1972, in Hyderabad, India.
Vinasam abhyasa asa nakasti tatum arati. So, the distinction between the living soul and the dead body, anyone can perceive. What is the distinction between a living body and the dead body? When a man is dead, his relatives cry, lament, "Oh, my father has gone, my son has gone." But the father, as you have seen, he is lying on the floor. Where he has gone? He is lying on the floor. Why you are crying, "Oh, my father has gone out"? That means the person who has gone away, who has left this body, you have not never seen. You have seen this body. So the body is lying there, and why you are crying, "My father has gone out"? So, any intelligent man can understand that the real father within the body was a different thing. But our ignorance is so great that we accept this body, this dead body, as my father. This body is not only dead now, it was always dead. Because the living soul was there within this dead body, it was moving. This is a fact. Just like a nice motor car is running. But when the driver is not there, the motor is lying there idle. If one identifies with the motor car, the driver of the car, that is foolishness. Jasya atma buddhi kunapi iti dhatuke. Anyone who is identifying this dead body or this material body, which is a composition of tridhatuka, kapha, pitta, vayu, some blood, flesh, and some secretion, and some bones, if anyone identifies this self with this lump of matter, then he is described as no better than cow and ass. Jasyatma buddhi kunapi tidhatuki sadhik kalatra disubhavama ijyadhi jatitha buddhi salile nakarhisi janesu avignesu saiva gopha. So, at the present moment especially, this ignorance is there always in the material world, that one is identifying this material body with the real self. The self, the soul, is different. It is not this material body. But our modern education, everything, advancement of knowledge, philosophy, everything, on the basis of on this wrong conception of life. So, to give a glimpse of idea, what is that soul, how it acts, here Krishna, Lord Krishna informs us, avinashi tu tad vidhi jena sarvam idam tatam vinasam abhyasa asa na kasti kartumarati. So, the soul, the presence of soul is perceived by the consciousness. The consciousness, just like the presence of sun, even I was blind, I could understand the sun is there because the sun, light and heat I'm experiencing. Without seeing the sun, when as soon as I come to the sun's side, I feel light and heat. Therefore, immediately I can understand there is sun. It is not very difficult. Similarly, just like we try to, when a man is dying, we try to feel whether the man is breathing or he is feeling touch sensation. These are the tests. So the touch sensation is there so long the soul is there. Now I am living body. If somebody pinches my body, because the consciousness is all over the body, so I feel somebody is pinching me. But when the consciousness is not there, if somebody chops off my body, I will not protest. Therefore, we should understand what is that living thing. That consciousness which is spreading all over this body, that is living force. Krishna says here, avinashi tu tad vidhi jena sarvam idam tatam. Jena, by that consciousness. The consciousness is spread all over the body. So Krishna says, that consciousness is avinashi. After the annihilation of this body, which we call dead, the consciousness is not dead. That we do not understand. There is no science. There is no philosophy. Everything based on a foolish assumption. They say the consciousness is made possible by combination of matter. This combination of matter, five elements, gross, the subtle elements they cannot see, even they see. So, proposition is that this consciousness is a symptom of combination of matter. That is Buddhist philosophy. They do not accept the existence of soul. The consciousness is a combination of matter. But if it is a fact, then why don't you, if some matter is lacking, why don't you bring that matter or chemical and inject in the dead body and make it regain consciousness? Why it is not possible? What is your argument? If you say consciousness is combination of matter, just like our motor car is being driven, so when the petrol is finished, matter, because motor car running means combination of matter, some machine made of matter and some oil acting, so it is running. Of course, the driver is there, a foolish person, they do not understand. A simply combination of matter will not act. There must be a driver, a living person. Then the motor car will go. So, supposing the combination of matter, that the petrol is finished, so we can bring petrol, again the motor runs. So if this body was running simply on combination of matter, and some matter is lacking, so why not bring that matter and put into it and it will run? But that is not possible. That was the living force which was running this body was a different element, spirit. Na sato vidyate bhava, na bhava vidyate sato, we have discussed this one. That is living force. And Krishna says, vinasam avyasya asya, this consciousness has no annihilation. Vinasam, nobody can kill this consciousness or the soul. One can do harm to this material body, but not to the spirit, soul and consciousness. Vinasam abhaya. Abhaya means which is never deteriorates. That is abhaya. Vinasam abhayasya asya na kashchit kartum arhati. Nobody can kill. Nobody can kill consciousness. Nobody can kill the soul. Therefore it is said, na hannate hannamane sarire. The consciousness or the spirit soul is never killed, never annihilated on the destruction of this body. So this is a great science. Unfortunately, the so-called scientist, he has no idea. He does not know. They simply say that we do not know, but we are trying to know. That's all right. But here is the knowledge, perfect knowledge in the Bhagavad Gita. Why don't you take it? That they will not take. They will go on speculating and promise falsely that in future we shall be able to inject some matter within the body and the body will again become alive. That is their dream. In the past history, it was never possible. At present also, it is not possible. How we can expect in future? But they are under delusion. They think like that we are making progress. At all, no progress, practically. They have no knowledge. That is their position. They have no knowledge. So, we have to understand from the authority. There are so many arguments. Now, if you say this body is dead because the blood has become white, blood corpuscles, they have now become white instead of becoming red. So, if that is the possible, so why don't you make the blood red by some chemical injection or by adding some color as soon as the blood becomes red? Why don't you do that? No, if you say that was natural redness, that natural redness cannot be God, then your science is defective. And even if we accept that natural redness is the cause of living force, there are many natural redness in the flower, in the jewels, why does it not move? So, all the arguments of these foolish scientists or so-called logicians, that can be, nullified if you are intelligent. We have to accept it, because it is said by Krishna, the Supreme Personality. Because we cannot say anything, why it is Avinashi, why this body is not Avinashi, but that consciousness is Avinashi, that we cannot explain. Therefore, we have to accept the version of the Supreme Authority. That is education. That is education. We cannot deny, because we cannot give any counter proposal. So how we can deny Krishna's proposal? Avinashi tadvidhi jena sarvamidam tatam. Jena sarvamidam tatam. This is also very significant. idam shariram. So, I am individual spirit soul. I am conscious. My consciousness is spread all over the body. But my consciousness is not spread over your body. If you are pinched by somebody, I don't feel. Because your consciousness is different from my consciousness. You cannot say that the consciousness is the same in you and me. No. Everyone is individual. Therefore, there is another consciousness. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Khetragancapi manaviddhi sarva khetresu bharata. I am Khetragya, conscious. I know about the pains and pleasures of my body. You know about the pains and pleasures of your body. I do not know about your pains and pleasures. You do not know about my pains and pleasures. Therefore, you are individual soul, I am individual. But there is another soul, super soul, that is Krishna. Ishara sarva bhutanam vidyesha arjuna tishtati. That super soul is present both in you and in me. Khetrangan chapi mang vidhi sarva khetresu bharat. Sarva khetresu bharat. In every living. Sarva khetresu, it is confirmed in the Vedic sutras, Brahma sutra. Annantarasam parvanu chayantarasam govindamadipurisam tamaham bhajami ekappasauratetam jagadannakoti. That super soul is present within this universe. Because that super soul is present within this universe, Krishna says, Vishtabhya aham, I enter within this world. Ekaṃsena sthito jagat. I do not enter, but my plenary portion, Ekaṃsena, Paramātmā. The Kṛodokṣāya Viṣṇu, he enters. The Gadbhodokṣāya Viṣṇu, he enters within this universe. And the Kṛodokṣāya Viṣṇu enters into everything, even in the atom. Therefore it is what. So that consciousness is there. Because the universal consciousness of Vishnu is there, therefore everything within the universe is working so nicely. Not that nature. Nature you can compare with your body. The material nature is there, but without the soul's presence, the consciousness being there, it will not work. Therefore, as the universe, material cosmic manifestation is working very nicely, you have to accept there is God. You cannot deny. So, that consciousness, super consciousness, that is different. You cannot say that I am the same. I have got super consciousness, that is not possible. Then if you have got super consciousness, why don't you feel about my pains and pleasures? The super consciousness is of Vishnu. That is all-pervading consciousness. That is also the same. Nature is the same. As I have got my consciousness all over this body, similarly, the super consciousness is there all over the universe. As I feel pains and pleasures on account of some disturbance on this body, similarly, as soon as we create some disturbance with this universal atmosphere, the Supreme Consciousness is disturbed. That disturbance is going on. Therefore, in spite of all arrangements, Purnamidam, Purnamada, Purnat, Purnamudat, by God's creation, everything is complete. There is no flaw. But because we are creating disturbances, the world situation is different. We are creating disturbances. By God's creation, everything is nice, everything is fine. Take for example, within this planet, there is sufficient place to grow food for all the population. Not only all the population at the present moment, but if the population increases 10 times, 20 times, still there is sufficient place to produce food for them. We are traveling all over the world 3 times a year, and we see in Australia and Africa and other countries, there are so much vacant places. And food can be produced. Enough food can be produced. Enough meal can be available for feeding all this population. That is God's arrangement. But the difficulty is that we are quarreling amongst ourselves. I am thinking Indian, somebody is thinking I am an American, somebody thinking I am Australian. You cannot come here. I cannot allow you to come to my country, the immigration department. Therefore the difficulty. By God's arrangement, there is everything complete. But I am disturbing. I am encroaching amongst God's property. This is mine. Therefore there is disturbance. Therefore the only solution of the whole world problem is Krishna consciousness. There is no other solution. The only solution. Krishna consciousness means when people will be educated to understand that this planet does not belong to America or India or Africa. Everything belongs. Sarva Loka Maheswaram, as Krishna says. I am the proprietor of all purpose, all the planets. When you understand this, that is Krishna consciousness. Then there will be peace. Therefore, this Krishna consciousness movement is very important to educate people, because foolishly they are claiming God's property, His property. Nothing belongs to us. Even this body does not belong to me. As soon as the time factor is finished, my body is finished. So I have got this body, say for 76 years ago, and say after 10 years or 5 years, it will be finished. So, before my body was created, the world was there. And when my body will finish, the world will remain there. Then how can I claim that this world belongs to me? This is called illusion. This is called ignorance. Mura. Mura. Mane, one does not know to whom the property belongs, but foolishly he is claiming that it is my property. This Krishna consciousness movement, in other words, it is spiritual communism. The material communism which is going on, that is defective, because this communist movement is centered around the state. But when there will be perfect communism, Ishavasamidam Sarvam, the center will be God, Krishna, that will be perfect. When everyone will understand that Krishna is the central point, Krishna is the proprietor, Krishna is the enjoyer, when perfectly we come to that Krishna consciousness, there will be peace and prosperity. Otherwise it is not possible. Therefore, of course, it is not possible that because the number of fools are greater. But still, as it is suggested in the Bhagavad Gita, jad jad acharati shrestha. Jad jad acharati shrestha. Tat tat eva itare jana. If the so-called leaders, they become Krishna conscious, they understand the philosophy, then others will follow. as at the present moment, because the leaders are foolish, blind, they have no spiritual knowledge, so all the population of the world becomes godless. Therefore, our appeal is to the leading personalities to understand this Krishna consciousness movement. Try to understand its philosophy, apply in life, and try to distribute this knowledge. Automatically others will accept. Thank you very much.